Introduction. It is no easy matter to give a precise definition of apocryphal gospels, or indeed of apocryphal writings as a whole. One could simplify things by merely stating that the adjective apocryphal covers all the texts collected in the New Testament Apocrypha, Antiopo, cf. General Bibliography, which was first edited by Edgar Hennecke and has been brought up to date by Wilhelm Schneemelger, but such a definition of our concept would be a circular fallacy, since the choice of texts included in this collection depends on a specific prior understanding of what apocryphal means. Besides this, the contents of this work have varied considerably in its successive editions. For example, the first edition, 1904, and the second, 1924, included the apostolic fathers, viz. The first and second letters of Clement, the letters of Ignatius, the letter of Polycarp, the letter of Barnabas, the Didache, and the shepherd of Hermas, and this group in its turn is an artificially assembled corpus which owes the name of apostolic fathers to an edition of the texts in 1672. From the third edition, 1959, onwards, greater attention was paid in the New Testament Apocrypha to the Nag Hammadi texts, cch 7 below. Some new texts were added but later removed, e.g. the letter to Dionysus and the sentences of Sextus, both included only in the second edition, and the Odes of Solomon, included only in the second and third editions. Christoph Marchis, who is preparing a new edition of this valuable collection of texts, has recently proposed that we should speak of ancient Christian Apocrypha. The term ancient indicates a chronological restriction to the period of the early church. This is important, because Apocrypha continued to be composed in the Middle Ages and in the modern period. Christian is intended to detach the concept from its fixation with the New Testament. It is, however, an open question whether this disposes of all the terminological problems. It is also intended to remove the Nag Hammadi documents including the Gospel of Thomas, the object of so much scholarly attention from the collection and to publish a new complete translation of these works. The word apocryphal comes from the Greek, apokrypos, and means literally hidden, concealed, secret. When it is applied to early Christian writings, it can have two meanings, which are antithetical and yet interrelated. 1. The term apocryphal is applied to secret revelations which are not included in the generally acknowledged corpus of revelatory documents, but are much more relevant in the eyes of particular groups than those doctrines which are professed and accepted in the public life of the Church. In this case, the term apocryphal has an unreservedly positive meaning, and it is used in this sense, for example, in the writings of Clement of Alexandria. 2. The adherents of orthodoxy in the Grosskirche, who defend a scriptural canon with clear boundaries, react by equating apocryphal with falsified, unreliable. In the Gelasian Decree, a 6th-century list of the scriptural canon, apocryphal appears in stereotypical manner alongside a large number of writings and means heretical. The intention is to make it clear that such writings possess no kind of authority whatsoever. Both these uses of the adjective apocryphal define a relationship between these documents and the New Testament canon, which was basically defined towards the end of the 3rd century. In regard to some of the so-called apocrypha, especially those composed at a later date, this correctly describes one factor which led to their production: the New Testament writings served as a criterion. The authors intended to complete these, to develop them, and to fill in supposed gaps. Sometimes the intention was also to promote the author's own theological views, where these differed from the New Testament. This is why the great genres of the New Testament were adopted: Gospels, Letters, Acts of the Apostles, and Apocalypses. This perspective, however, fails to do justice to one important aspect. This is why Walter Rebell's definition of the Apocrypha as rival texts to the New Testament is applicable only to some of these writings, not by any means to their totality. Some of the texts which we call apocryphal are from the early period, and became apocryphal only at a later date, as Dieter Luhrmann points out in his title, Fragments of Gospels which became apocryphal. This means that their genuine Sitz im Leben is the wide current of early Christian literature antecedent to the process of the formation of a scriptural canon. There was no such canon which could have provided a criterion for the authors or for the evaluation of their writings. There is a recent tendency, prominent in North American scholarship, cf., e.g. Helmut Kuster, though not found exclusively there, to argue that some apocryphal texts are not only just as ancient as the New Testament, but in fact even older than the writings collected in the canon. Taken to its extreme consequences, this position holds that the Apocrypha were used as sources by the New Testament authors, and that they are accordingly of central significance for the reconstruction of the historical origins of Christianity. It is exceedingly difficult to maintain such an unnuanced position, and one must be rather cautious about this whole line of argument, since it risks simply replacing an older ideology, which was convinced of the superiority of the canon, by a newer ideology, which favors a non-canonical, unorthodox, free literature, and Christianity. To take one example, John Dominic Crossan's blurb on the dust jacket of the translations edited by Robert J. Miller makes promises that simply cannot be fulfilled: everything you need to empower your own search for the historical Jesus. Global judgments are out of place here. Rather, we must examine each individual case and only then construct the appropriate hypothesis, and even if our general impression tends more in the direction of the older assessment, this owes nothing to apologetic aims. On the contrary, it is the detached academic study of these texts, as far as detachment is possible, which leads to such a judgment. Let me explicitly state one methodological option which plays a role here. When one compares Gospels which have become apocryphal with Gospels which have become canonical, one must pay more attention than earlier scholars to a phenomenon brought to light in recent scholarship, viz. Secondary orality. On this, cf. The important work by Samuel Berskog. In many cases, oral traditions are antecedent to the written texts, and these oral traditions continued to flow alongside the transmission of the texts. And it is very important to note that even material which had found a written form continued to be transmitted in oral form in the classical period. This is obvious in the case of the canonical Gospels, when one reflects on the fact that they were regularly read aloud in worship. The narratives in the canonical Gospels thus enter a phase of new, secondary orality, where these texts are exposed to a free reformulation and above all to a harmonizing assimilation of the various versions. This too may be a route which permitted the canonical Gospels to exercise indirect influence on the composition of apocryphal texts. In the selection of texts for this introduction to the apocryphal Gospels, we shall have to proceed pragmatically, without letting ourselves be hampered too much by problems of definitions and the state of our available sources. The primary consequence of this approach is that we shall have to take into account the Nag Hammadi writings in several chapters of this book. The criteria guiding the treatment of a text in greater or less detail, or for omitting it altogether, are its antiquity, contents, significance, the extent to which it is known to readers, and its historical influence. I hope that the summaries, despite their brevity, and the bibliographical indications will encourage readers to set out on their own journeys of exploration in a fascinating world which is all too little known. I conclude this introduction with an example of a canon list not because of a consistently negative evaluation of a whole list of theologians, but rather in order to give an idea of the quantity of apocryphal writings which were known in the 6th century. Our example is the Gelasian Decree, mentioned above, cf. Antiochoi, 47, 49, for further information, above all on the incriminated theologians, cf. Ivan Dobschutz, 238,4. The remaining writings which have been compiled or been recognized by heretics or schismatics the Catholic and Apostolic Roman Church does not in any way receive, of these we have thought it right to cite below some which have been handed down and which are to be avoided by Catholics. In the first place we confess that the Synod at Ariminum which was convened by the Emperor Constantius, the son of Constantine, through the Prefectoris is damned from then and now and forever. Itinerary, Book of Travels, under the name of the Apostle Peter, which is called the Nine Books of the Holy Clement. Apocryphal. Acts under the name of the Apostle Andrew. Apocryphal. Acts under the name of the Apostle Thomas. Apocryphal. Acts under the name of the Apostle Peter. Apocryphal. Acts under the name of the Apostle Philip. Apocryphal. Gospel under the name of Matthias. Apocryphal. Gospel under the name of Barnabas. Apocryphal. Gospel under the name of James the Younger. Apocryphal. Gospel under the name of Thomas, which the Manichaeans use. Apocryphal. Gospel under the name of Bartholomew. Apocryphal. Gospel under the name of Andrew. Apocryphal. Gospels which Lucian has forged. Apocryphal. Gospels which Hesychius has forged. Apocryphal. Book about the childhood of the Redeemer. Apocryphal. Book about the birth of the Redeemer and about Mary or the midwife. Apocryphal. Book which is called by the name of the Shepherd. Apocryphal. All books which Lucius, the disciple of the devil, has made. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Foundation. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Treasure. Apocryphal. Book about the daughters of Adam, Leptogenesis. Apocryphal. Cento about Christ, put together in Virgilian lines. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Acts of Thecla and Apol. Apocryphal. Book which is ascribed to Nepos. Apocryphal. Books of the sayings, compiled by heretics and denoted by the name of Sixtus. Apocryphal. Revelation which is ascribed to Paul. Apocryphal. Revelation which is ascribed to Thomas. Apocryphal. Revelation which is ascribed to Stephen. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Homegoing of the Holy Mary. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Penitence of Adam. Apocryphal. Book about the giant Augeas, of whom the heretics assert that after the flood he fought with the dragon. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Testament of Job. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Penitence of Origen. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Penitence of the Holy Cyprian. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Penitence of Jams and Mombers. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Portion of the Apostles. Apocryphal. Book which is called the Great Plate, of the Apostles. Apocryphal. Book which is called Canons of the Apostles. Apocryphal. The Book Physiologus, compiled by heretics and called by the name of the Blessed Ambrose. Apocryphal. The History of Eusebius Pamphili. Apocryphal. Works of Tertullian. Apocryphal. Works of Lactantius, later edition, or of Fermianus or of the African. Apocryphal. Works of Postumianus and of Gallus. Apocryphal. Works of Montanus, of Priscilla, and of Maximilla. Apocryphal. Works of Faustus the Manichaean. Apocryphal. Works of Commodianus. Apocryphal. Works of the other Clement, of Alexandria. Apocryphal. Works of Vetsius Cyprian. Apocryphal. Works of Arnobius. Apocryphal. Works of Taconius. Apocryphal. Works of Cassian, a presbyter in Gaul. Apocryphal. Works of Victorinus of Petra. Apocryphal. Works of Faustus of Rhes in Gaul. Apocryphal. Works of Frumentius Secus. Apocryphal. Epistle of Jesus to Abgar. Apocryphal. Epistle of Abgar to Jesus. Apocryphal. Passion, Martyr Acts, of Syricus and of Iulita. Apocryphal. Passion of Georgius. Apocryphal. writing which is called Interdiction, Exorcism, of Solomon. Apocryphal. All amulets which have been compiled not, as those persons feign, in the name of the angels, but rather in that of the demons. Apocryphal. These and the like, what Simon Magus, Nicholas, Cerinthus, Martian, Basilides, Ebion, Paul of Samosata, Photinus, and Bonatius, who suffered from similar error, also Montanus with his detestable followers, Apollinaris, Valentinus the Manichaean, Faustus the African, Sabellius, Arius, Macedonius, Eunomius, Novatus, Sabbatius, Callistus, Donatus, Eustatius, Iovinus, Pelagius, Iulianus of Eclenum, Silistius, Maximian, Priculian from Spain, Nestorius of Constantinople, Maximus the Cynic, Lamptius, Dioscorus, Eunuchs, Peter and the other Peter, of whom the one besmirched Alexandria and the other Antioch, Agesias of Constantinople with his associates, and what also all disciples of heresy and of the heretics or schismatics, whose names we have scarcely preserved, have taught or compiled, we acknowledge is to be not merely rejected but excluded from the whole Roman Catholic and Apostolic Church and with its authors and the adherents of its authors to be damned in the inextricable shackles of anathema forever.